Hey, it's Nate from the Bike Company. We're going to go through our new coil calculator real quick and kind of give you some ideas of what you're seeing and some ideas of what you're not seeing. We're going to start with what you can see on that coil spring calculator. This has been built to give you an idea of what the coil is actually doing through a section of travel. And it's pretty easy to do with a coil because it's set at a pounds per inch is how they measure it. So it takes a certain level of load to compress that spring 1 inch, and then to compress that spring the second inch, and then the third inch or whatever. So coil springs are known to be a little bit more plush because of that. They don't have the ramp rate that a air spring is gonna have. So you're able to pretty easily kind of glance through that. Where that becomes interesting is not a lot of people realize that utilizing preload, there's actually a crossover on coils, and you can choose to have a coil that sits with a lower ramp rate or a coil that sits with a higher ramp rate. Not always touched on, so we want to go through that. Now, when you're looking at coils, you've got some critical measurements you need to take into account. One is ID. It needs to be the proper inner diameter to clear the damper and not come off the spring perches. So we work in a Fox on Fox world. There's really no issues there if that's what you're doing. But if you're starting to cross through brands, do take a look at that. You've got total length. Each damper can hold a specific range based on that preload perch moving up and down on the threaded body. Shorter coil is going to be slightly lighter. I don't know that it's enough lighter that I would necessarily be searching for months and months for that shortest coil that fits in there. But it is a factor, so you need to have the total length has to be acceptable to work with what you're got mounted on your bike. You've got coil stroke. This is a critical one as well. The coil stroke, like your shock stroke, is a physical measurement in vertical travel that it can do. When your coil hits that maximum, it does what's called coil bind, and the coils, the steel rings actually sit on top of each other. The spring rate goes infinite. Essentially, the bike becomes a hardtail. In dirt riding, we don't want that. You might hear about coil bind in some track cars or some track motorcycles, stuff like that. Different world. In our world, coil bind is no good. So you want to make sure that your coil stroke is greater than your shock stroke, your damper stroke, including preload. So we're going to come into the preload here in a second, and we'll go through kind of the beauties of all of that stuff. But it is a factor. Do be aware to have a greater coil stroke than your shock stroke. Spring rate on a coil, like we mentioned earlier, is done in pounds per inch. Now, what that equates to is that a certain load compresses the spring a certain amount. You can kind of calculate back and forth and see where you want to be on that. What this calculator does is it allows you to take a look at coils that are going to be close on either side so that you can look at ramp rate and or the total pressure that's coming off at the 60 to 100% of that travel. And the reason that we can do that with different rated coils is through preload. By utilizing that preload adjustment, we're able to move the spring into its travel and take up some pounds, right? So now that next inch is going to require a greater amount of pressure to move it than it would have had this coil not been preloaded or been preloaded to the minimum, which with Fox is, I think, 8 clicks. They have a maximum of 26 clicks published. So that's what we've got on our calculator here for you. You can see that I'm able to get my sag point, which is 30%, it's going to be whatever number it's going to be. I can get there with two different coil springs, and maybe three, depending on what you're looking at, in terms of the pound ratings. I can either run a lower spring rate with more preload, and that's going to have less ramp at the end, or I could run the higher spring rate with less preload, but it will have more ramp at the end. So kind of like volume spacers on your air shock, you are able to modify the bottom out and deep travel support with a coil, even though it is a linear product because you've got crossover through the preload. That's what this calculator is going to show you. And it allows you to play with it. It'll publish out on the right-hand side you know, the available coils. You can link to them on our site, see, you know, what you want to do with them, both steel and the SLS for Fox. What this calculator doesn't do that you need to take into some consideration and talk with your resources or really think about what your bike's doing. As your spring compresses and decompresses, it's going through linkage. That linkage is changing both it's going to have a leverage ratio based on the rear travel to the shock, as well as, you know, whatever size linkages are coming off things. But as the linkage, we're going to really simplify it here just so you can kind of understand it. And then you can extrapolate, this is happening at every linkage point. But when you start out, let's say your linkage is here and your shock is here. As you do that, it's called a rising rate until it gets to 90 degrees. The coil is actually only pushing, or even an air spring, is only pushing 1-to-1 at a 90 degree interface between the lever arm and the spring or the air spring, whatever it is. When you look at a hydraulic press, it's totally vertical. It's always at 90, so that's how that works. We're talking about linkage rates falling and rising. So you may have a situation where it comes to a 90 degree real early in the travel and falls far away from it. You might prefer the more aggressive ramp of the higher spring at a lower preload. Or, you know, maybe your 1-to-1 doesn't come until very late in the stroke, in which case you might not need all of that ramp at the end. So there still is a lot of you having to look at what your bike's doing or understand what your bike's doing, work with your resources. You can kind of back into it if you know, yeah, this is what my bike is performing like, and I've got my compression settings correct. I've got my high speed compression correct, my low speed compression correct. There is a variable to it. So we're not trying to tell you, here's the be all end all, but we just thought it'd be fun to have a calculator that people could look at. If you have a shock on your bike and you're thinking, I'm not using my full travel all the time, but it's the sag set correct. Well, this will give you some options to look at. Vice versa, if you have a bike where sag set, you know, is as low as I want to set it, and man, I'm just running through travel, you might look at running a different preload and getting that ramp rate up with your coil spring. So we invite you to utilize it, take a look at it. If you have questions purchasing a coil or purchasing a damper and a coil or purchasing a damper coil and a bike, hit our guys up. We love to work with this stuff. This is what we do, and this is the world we've lived in since 1999 at the bike company. So questions beyond that, look into our Pro Tunes, look into taking that performance window and really narrowing it down to your particulars, and that'll take your riding to the next level. So hope you enjoyed this. Hope you learned something on that coil spring calculator, and we look forward to seeing you here at bikeco.com.